Hey guys, today I'll be reviewing Etude House Fixing Tints. There are now a total of 8 shades in the line and I've picked up 4 of them. 3 of the shades here are recently created in collaboration with Jeyu, who is a beauty YouTuber. Let's start with the packaging. They come in muted and almost velvety looking plastic tubes with clear caps. I love that the color of the tubes are almost identical to each of the shades, so it is very easy to identify which shade is which. It has a very long flat doe foot applicator which lay nicely onto the lips and distributes the product evenly. As for the texture, I would say it is very close to a liquid lipstick without much weight on the lip. It fixes onto the lip after a right amount of time you need to blend it. The blendability is superb despite its texture being similar to liquid lipsticks. Once it gets fixed and dries completely, the transfer is minimum and it barely budges. Of course, that is if you apply the right amount of product and not in a thick layer. You can see how hard I'm rubbing them with a clean cotton pad. Here I am rubbing them again with cotton pads soaked in micellar water. I noticed that the longer it sits on the lip, it lasts even more. So I've been enjoying these babies underneath the masks. I can say that this is pretty mask proof as advertised. The only downside I found is that it can be a bit sticky when drying and for a bit after it dries down. But don't worry, you will barely notice it after a couple of hours. Shall we move on to the swatches? First, we have number 8 Dusty Beige. It is a muted pink and has wider base than I've imagined it to be. It is opaque and doesn't apply patchy for a shade like this. It would definitely be a MLBB shade for those with cooler skin tones. For those with warm skin tones like myself, stay tuned for more flattering shades after this. Next is number 7 Cranberry Plum. For some reason, its consistency is a little runnier than the rest, although the finish and application seem to be the same. This would definitely brighten any skin tones and it has perfect balance of warmth and cool. This is my favorite shade out of all. If I were to recommend just one shade from this line, this would be it. This is number 4, Ginger Milktea from the original line. It is a warm muted orange that has a lot of white base just like earlier shade. Again, it applies opaque in one layer or dip. Despite it being a beautiful shade, I would not wear this on its own on my light medium skin tone unless I'm pairing this with a bold eye look, because as you can see, it sort of washes out my face. Last but not least, we have number 6 Soft Walnut. It is an orange brown shade that looks beautiful on warm tones. I also love that it has a tint of rose when applied on the lips. I think it depends on your natural lip color because it looks more orangey when swatched on my arm. Here are arm swatches of all 4 beautiful shades. I'll be comparing these fixing tints with Peripera Slick products that I have. First shade for comparison is Dusty Beige. Against Peripera Ink The Velvet in Ballet Pink, and Ink The Velvet in Rosy Nude. They apply very differently, obviously because they are in different formula. However, they are similar in shades and finishes on the lips. Etude's Fixing Tint is the most long-lasting among these. In terms of how it feels on the lip, Peripera's Ink Mood Matte Tint has the lightest weight, followed by Etude's Fixing Tint. It's not that Ink The Velvet is heavy on the lip, just that when comparing these three, I can feel it on the lip the most. Next, we have Cranberry Plum. Up against for colour comparison with Peripera's Ink Mood Matte Tint in Oatmeal Rose. Followed by Peripera Ink The Velvet in Star Plum Pink. Lastly, we are swatching Soft Walnut. And Peripera's Ink The Velvet in shade Good Brick. Soft Walnut is softer, and it's as if Good Brick is a vibrant sister of Soft Walnut. Let's take a quick look at recommended shade combinations before we end this video. Ginger Milktea and Soft Walnut, one of my favorite combinations under warm tone. For cool tone, it has got to be Cranberry Plum on the inner lip and Dusty Beige on the outer part. I have also paired up Dusty Beige and Soft Walnut. It creates an interesting mix of cool and warm tones, which I love. This is all I have for today, guys. They are long-lasting and the colors are so beautiful. I'm in love with these Etude's Fixing Tints more than I thought I would be. These will be best friends for many of us during these mask periods for sure. Thanks for watching till the end, and I hope that this video was helpful for you. See you in my next video.